impossible ancient feats of ancient engineering found throughout modern-day Japan. Polygonal stonework of gigantic proportions, ancient forts, and temples found all over Japan, which we have previously distinguished, these were constructed upon far older mysterious masonry techniques, the most abundant of which we have come to know as polygonal. Tucked away within rural Japan is a megalith, known as Ishinohoden. At first glance, this particular megalith looks as though it is floating in midair. The reason for this is due to the civilization's abrupt departure. As such, the stone has not been completely liberated from the bedrock it is still attached to. Clearly, at the final stage of excavation, the stone is literally hanging by a thread due to the location of the excavation. The fact that the stone itself has protected its base from erosion. The megalith has remained attached to this small seam of rock for untold millennia. The defining reason why we attribute this stone to a now lost civilization. It is its sheer size, measuring an impressive 5.7 by 6.4 by 7.2 meters. The stone also weighs an estimated 500 tons. It is meaning that the techniques are indeed the technology used to cut and transport the stone. It remains an unexplainable feat of ancient engineering, largely dismissed by academics the world over. These gigantic stones, however, are a legacy that, due to their immense size, it is likely to still be present here on our planet far after our own civilization has been and gone. Possibly, hopefully, we will have inhabited another planet within our solar system. This time, meaning that we may be the first to alter our destiny, ultimately settling away from the inevitable. Additionally, just like the many other sites which we have successfully identified within Japan, as the work of a now lost civilization, a temple was later built at the site. Although attributed to civilization within permitted timelines, the megalith has been believed to be holy and has been venerated since ancient times. According to mainstream study, which although not publicized, it was literally forced upon academic institutions as they continue to attempt to appear transparent, all the while actively avoiding the task of explaining not only who and when this stone was cut by, but how this ancient civilization was intended to transport said stones to their final locations. The official version is predictably a claim that the rock was intended to be a tomb. However, just as we would have expected, there is no scientific information as to who quarried the stone, or indeed what intentions they had for its eventual purpose. Who cut the Ishinohoden megalith? How did ancient civilizations move such gigantic stones, sometimes thousands?